Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Today I have the Dell PowerEdge R6625 server. This is one of Dell's 16th generation platforms, or at least I think it is. Nobody cares about the generation anymore. Just pop in a new processor and call it a day. Thankfully, each generation for Dell does include a slight reference number change. In this case, the 15th generation R6525 is now the R6625. See what they did there with that second digit? This one has dual 4th generation AMD EPYC CPUs, with CPUs that can provide up to 128 cores of high-performance goodness, each. It's based off next-gen Zen 4 architecture and even the next-gen Zen 4C architecture for AMD's recent EPYC CPU release. That would be like the 4th generation and a half, I suppose. At 1U, the Dell PowerEdge R6625 is the smaller sibling to the 2U Dell PowerEdge R7625 we did a few weeks back. You can see that here. If this was an Intel-based system, it would be the R760, which has dual 4th generation Intel Xeon scalable processors. Yeah, we did that one too. What all these platforms have in common is support for DDR5 memory modules and PCIe 5.0, not to mention significantly improved compute performance and more cores. In fact, with the latest update to the 4th generation AMD EPYC 9004 series processors announced on June 13th of this year, AMD now has two SKUs that support 128 cores each, the AMD EPYC 9754 with 128 cores and 256 threads, and another one, the EPYC 9754S, which appears to be single-threaded with 128 cores, but only 128 threads. AMD boasts the best data center CPUs with the world record to prove it. And these would be in energy efficiency, business applications, including fintech and digital rendering, plus data management and analytics, infrastructure and data management. Basically this. I copied that right off their website. AMD also released three new EPYC SKUs that include the second generation 3DV cache technology. Remember the initial release during the third gen Milan era? 3DV cache technology provided a threefold increase in L3 cache from the almost standard 256 megabytes to 768 megabytes. That additional L3 cache improved performance for specific applications. Those last four applications in the list, electronic design automation, computational fluid dynamics, and the others, were really played up when first released. This list is still valid now, but now offers even better performance for these applications with second-gen 3DV cache technology. The 9684X offers a 4.5-fold increase in L3 cache from the almost standard 256 megabytes of cache on the general processors to 1,152 megabytes of L3 cache. With that amount of L3 cache, you get vastly improved data queuing at the CPU for faster results, instead of waiting for all those nanoseconds for retrieval from the upfront storage. Getting a little off track here. I mean, we are talking about the Dell PowerEdge R6625 server, but that said, this platform would not be quite as impressive without those AMD EPYC CPUs. I had to say a little something about those new CPUs, especially those offering up to 128 cores and 256 virtual threads. Interested in the Dell PowerEdge R6625? Look no further than IT Creations. We have this system in stock, and for a limited time, you can save $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure on our site that comes in at $5,000 or more. Just mention this video and click that link. It's just that simple. The front of the chassis features the same control panel and telltale lights as found on the R7625. On the right, a control panel with a system health button that can also be paired with an iDRAC Quick Sync 2 button for use with a smartphone or tablet and the OpenManage mobile app. Beside those, status LEDs to help identify failed hardware at a glance, including drives, temperature, electrical, memory, and PCIe. Green is good, solid amber indicates you have a problem. I will point out that iDRAC Quick Sync 2 is only supported on certain configurations. On the right, a VGA port, USB port, micro AB, USB, iDRAC Direct port, iDRAC Direct status LED, and the power on button. Once you remove the LCD-enabled bezel, plenty of options once again for storage. The most interesting storage option is support for up to 16 E3.S drives, which surprisingly don't provide the highest capacity compared to standard implementations using SATA, SAS, or NVMe with a 12-bay 2.5-inch disk configuration. There's also a 14-bay E3.S version. Both E3.S options are used as direct drives for a host server. For standard drive support, a 3.5-inch bay chassis with 4 bays along the bottom has room for an optional optical device on the left side. That one only supports SATA or SAS drives, and the latter only with a SAS controller. 2.5-inch drive options include either an 8-bay chassis or 10-bay option, which will completely cover the front of the system with drive bays. On the back of the system, there are dual redundant PSUs with varying wattages depending on how the system is loaded up. If in need of additional storage, there is an option to install either two 2.5-inch drive bays or two of those E3.S drives. An optional boot-optimized storage subsystem, or BOS, can be installed on the far right of the system. The BOS is simply used to boot the system, leaving the upfront and rear drive bays available for storage. Along the bottom of the chassis are the flexible I/O options, including a LAN on motherboard with two 1 gigabit Ethernet ports in that first one. Next to that is an OCP card mezzanine slot that can support several different OCP 3.0 cards with different port configurations and link speeds. It's easily removable from the back of the system and connects to a PCIe 5.0x8 slot. It will also extend the network controller options while preserving the limited PCIe slots. Although you can still install additional PCIe-based network controllers in one of the three PCIe slots above. An I/O panel with a dedicated iDRAC Ethernet port also has a USB 2.0 port on top, USB 3.0 port, and a VGA port. That VGA port is optional. The system comes standard with air cooling, but an alternate configuration includes optional direct liquid cooling, or DLC. The tubes would exit the chassis right where that VGA port is currently located. I will mention that the previous generation, the R6625, only supported Linux-based operating systems. But with this one, you get Windows Server plus those Linux-based operating systems and VMware. There are several ways to manage the system at chassis or remotely. The dedicated RJ45 iDRAC Ethernet port on the back, the micro USB iDRAC Direct port on the front right server ear, where you can also connect a monitor, and the optional QuickSync 2, which will enable you to access the system from a smartphone or tablet after you download and install the OpenManage mobile app. This system supports iDRAC 9.0 Direct for remote management of the system. However, it can be upgraded to support iDRAC Enterprise or Data Center. OpenManage Enterprise and the OpenManage Power Manager can also be included for managing multiple systems and is also available in varying licensing levels depending on your infrastructure needs. If you want to learn more about iDRAC, check out our brief overview that covers iDRAC 9.0 Enterprise. Once we pop the cover off, you can see the layout with the drives up front, the back plane, an area where there might be a front PERC controller just in front of the four dual fan modules. Again, options for PERC or PowerEdge RAID controllers with HBAs, just internal controllers, or using the integrated S160 controller. Then the CPUs and memory modules and the PCIe slots in back. The NIC ports, OCP card, and that I/O board are all separate circuit boards that can be removed, replaced, or upgraded as necessary. Although the OCP card is the only one accessible from the back, that doesn't entail removing the entire motherboard to replace. There are three PCI risers for up to three PCI Gen 5 slots, all by 16 and either full height or low profile, depending on which risers you choose to install. And you do have choices, even an option with no risers. Additional NICs and hard drive controllers can be installed in the risers depending on the application. You will need to install a PERC if you plan on running SAS drives. The system came with a 12th generation Dell PERC H9651 front. It mounts just behind the hard drives and can RAID SATA, SAS, or NVMe drives with a full range of RAID options. But again, there are other options for HD controllers too. Keep in mind, if the optional hard drive cages for either two 2.5-inch drives or two E3.S drives are installed, that will detract from the number of available PCI slots. Depending on which risers are installed, the system will accept up to two 75-watt single-wide GPU, FPGA, or accelerators. GPUs with that wattage profile include the NVIDIA A2 and the tried-and-true NVIDIA T4. That NVIDIA A2 GPU actually just uses between 40 and 60 watts and features Ampere architecture. Those CPUs I went on and on about reside in a new socket, so those previous generations of EPYC CPUs, Naples, Rome, and Milan, are not compatible. CPUs of up to 400 watts are supported, opening the door for perhaps more options in the future. The processor interconnect is now twice as fast at 32 gigatransfers per second compared to only 16 gigatransfers per second on the previous generation. So in addition to all those improved Zen cores featuring Zen 4 architecture, it's quite clear there are significant performance gains from memory too. The new R6625 has only 24 memory module slots compared to the R6525's 32 memory module slots. Of course, the previous generation only had 8 memory channels to work with, and now with the 9004 series Genoa AMD EPYC CPUs, 12 memory channel architecture. And with DDR5 RDIMMs, a 60% increase in speed at 4800 megatransfers per second over DDR4 memory speeds. Only RDIMM memory modules are supported. The Dell PowerEdge R6625 is a flexible platform for a number of applications and offers several storage configurations. But if you need more storage, the Dell PowerEdge R7625 provides up to 26 2.5-inch drive bays plus support for double-wide high-performance GPUs. Both are considered workhorse platforms in Dell's enterprise lineup and highly configurable for a number of applications. If you like this video, give us the thumbs up and maybe even subscribe to our channel, as I will be looking at more of the latest platforms as they become available. If you have any comments or questions on this platform or any other, just post them in the comments section below. I placed a few links in the description if you want more information on the Dell PowerEdge R6625 server. Need something else? Try itcreations.com. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.